You will be able to find a solution literally at a touch of a finger. Let's get started to solve this problem using Lagrange's mean value theorem. So, using Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have to prove that. We have to prove this inequality. For that, let us assume that f of x is equal to here tan inverse of x. So, this is tan inverse of x. And f dash of x will be 1 by 1 plus x square. And f dash of c will be, in place of x, we have to write 1 by c square. So, according to Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So here f of x is equal to tan inverse of x, and f of b will be tan inverse of b, and f of a will be tan inverse of a. So if I substitute here, then f dash of c is equal to tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a. So our f dash of c is ready. And then what is f dash of c? F dash of c from equation 1, we have 1 by 1 plus c square is equal to tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a. So this is equation 2. We have to keep it as equation 2, and this is equation 1. So after that, according to the Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have c belongs to open a comma b. That is, so this is a and this is b. In between there will be c. C belongs to open a comma b. Therefore, a less than c less than b. So for that, we have c belongs to. C belongs to open a comma b, which means that a less than c less than b. So we want c square. So for that, I am squaring throughout. So a square less than c square less than b square, and I am adding 1. So 1 plus a square less than 1 plus c square less than 1 plus b square. Now I want the reciprocal of 1 plus c square. For that, 1 by 1 plus a square, so less than will become greater than, 1 by 1 plus c square greater than 1 by 1 plus b square. So from equation 2, what is the value of 1 by 1 plus c square? 1 by 1 plus c square is nothing but c. I am writing 1 by 1 plus a square. From equation 2, I am writing this tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a, which is greater than 1 by 1 plus b square. Now, if I multiply throughout b minus a, then b minus a by 1 plus a square is greater than, see, if I multiply here, and I can cancel these two, and this will be tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a by 1 plus b square. So this is the inequality which we obtained using Lagrange's mean value theorem. See, once again, if I take, so to get this inequality, I have to take f of x is equal to tan inverse of x, and I have to find the value of f dash of c. And according to the Lagrange's mean value theorem, so this is the formula, that is f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. In this, we have f of x is equal to tan inverse of x, f of b will be tan inverse of b, and f of a will be tan inverse of a. In this, if I substitute f of b is equal to tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a. So what is f dash of c? F dash of c is nothing but 1 by 1 plus c square. Our equation 2 is ready, and after substituting the value of 1 by 1 plus c square as tan inverse of b minus tan inverse of a by b minus a, and multiplying with b minus a throughout the equation, and we got the inequality. So this is the most important problem using Lagrange's mean value theorem. And there is another inequality here. We have to show that for x positive, 1 plus x less than e power x less than 1 plus x into e power x. This is also we have to show using Lagrange's mean value theorem. For that, I am considering let f of x is equal to, here it is e power x. Here in this equality there is e power x, and so I am taking as e power x. And again, if I make first derivative, it will be again e power x, and f dash of c will be e power c. As you can see here, according to which theorem, Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So what is f of b? We have f of x is equal to e power x, then f of b will be e power b, and f of a will be e power a. And if I substitute, it will be f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So this is the most important thing, f dash of c. So after getting f dash of c, according to the Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have c belongs to open a comma b. So a, this is b, in between there will be c. So a less than c less than b. So I want the value here. What is f dash of c here? From 1, f dash of c is equal to e power c. I am substituting in place of f dash of c, I am writing e power c is equal to e power b minus e power a by b minus a. So this is the thing which I am going to use. And the next one here is, I want e power c. So I am raising power as e power a less than e power c less than e power b. So in place of e power c, I can write, you can consider it as equation 2. From 2, we can write as e power a less than, in place of this I am writing e power b minus e power a by b minus a less than, this is e power b. And see here, there is a thing, that is b minus a less than or equal to. What is a and b? So we have to take let a comma b be 0 comma x. Here we have to take 0 comma x. In place of a I am taking 0, and in place of b I am taking x. Then what will happen there? It will happen as e power 0 less than e power x minus e power 0 less than, what is b? That is x minus 0, and here it is e power x. So this will be 1 less than e power x minus 1 by x less than e power x. If I multiply with x, then this will be x less than e power x minus 1 less than x into e power x. If I add 1, then it will be x plus 1 less than e power x less than 1 plus x into e power x for every x. So this is the inequality. This is the inequality which is asked to show that. So 1 plus x less than e power x less than 1 plus x into e power x. So our f of x, we have to choose f of x as e power x, and f dash of x will be again e power x, and f dash of c will be e power c. And according to the Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So f of b is ready and f of a is also ready, and after substituting in the formula of Lagrange's mean value theorem, we have f dash of c is equal to e power c. Therefore, e power c is equal to e power b minus e power a by b minus a. And we also have that c belongs to open a comma b. So, in between a comma b, there will be c. Therefore, this inequality holds, a less than, c less than b. So, we want e power c. Therefore, I am raising the power to e to the power of exponential to the power of a less than e to the power of c less than e to the power of b. In place of e power c, I am writing this formula, that is according to equation 2, we have e power b minus e power a by b minus a. And in this, what is a and what is b? We have to take that a is equal to 0 and b is equal to x. We have to take the open interval of 0 comma x. So after substituting a is equal to 0 and b is equal to x, we got this inequality. So using Lagrange's mean value theorem. Hope you all guys understand. Please consider subscribing and let's stay connected, and have a look at my next video, and don't forget to share it to your friends and leave a comment below. And thank you so much for staying till the end.